the way in which the radiation damages cancer cells is a bit different between IMRT and proton therapy. IMRT primarily causes single-stranded DNA breaks. Proton therapy, because they're heavy charged particles, actually do more damage. They have a higher frequency of complex and compounded double-stranded breaks, which are harder for cancer cells to repair. So you might predict that dose for dose, proton therapy may do a better job of killing cancer cells. When we compare the control rates from our proton-treated patients to, for example, the IMRT results from Memorial Sloan Kettering, we find that with intermediate and high-risk disease, our control rates are in fact better than theirs. When we compare our compressed treatment schedule that's given a little shorter period of time to exactly the same schedule treated in the national RTOG trial that used IMRT and 3D conformal radiation, we see the same thing, that our control rates are better. Now, you could say, how do we know that that's not just a different makeup of patients? So, but it is intriguing. It would fit with what we might have predicted from the radiobiology. And so what we need is a well-done prospective trial to compare the two that would eliminate those questions. And in fact, that is currently open. It's recently opened a trial designed by our medical director that's PCORI funded and has most all of the proton facilities in the country cooperating. A large number of centers, academic centers that don't have protons as well. And selecting patients the same way, it'll accumulate 3,000 patients in a fairly short period of time and allow us to really compare those results one to the other.